Welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm the Metaverse Pirate and already made two episodes about Space Atlas VR. It's a demo, it's free for nothing, so you can use it. In the future they will ask money for it, so let's explore this Space Atlas VR. Here we go. Press the button start. There's a tutorial. Let's start the tutorial. Let's start with the basic one.
Welcome to the tutorial of Space Atlas VR. It is designed to familiarize you with the Atlas user interface, which is designed to be hand-controlled. Please complete each required action to proceed. Press Start to begin the tutorial. At any time, look to your left and to your right. The Atlas user interface is spread on now. Do the same with the blue panel with the tag navigation. Finally, look at the large red panel further away from the platform. The Atlas is controlled mainly through buttons. These buttons behave much like those of a keyboard. Now click the open button beneath the Earth model on your right. Some 3D objects can be picked up with your virtual. 3D objects can 3D miniatures are a special kind of 3D objects. They are small glass spheres like the one you have just manipulated. The 3D miniatures can be picked up with your controllers, rotated and scaled like shown before. 3D miniatures are used to control certain large 3D models shown in the main scene. Pick up the 3D miniature of the Earth, scale and rotate it until the equator line is aligned with the red ring. Some 3D models can be exploded to...
The tutorial explains it.
Welcome to the Space Atlas experience.
There are three chapters, Earth, Solar System, and the Universe. Already did many things. You can have tools options. This is a free version, so some things are very limited. So let's go to the Earth. Loading. It's made in Unity. Unity is a program. So where am I? Okay, yes, the Earth. Earth from space. Well, there you can see everything. You have the data layers, geographic map, temperature, anomaly. So the climate change, you can see the climate change in America compared from year to year, the active fire, forest fires and so on. So there's even a artificial intelligence.
Space is conventionally defined as beginning 100 kilometers above sea level, where the residual atmosphere is extremely thin and the temperature is about minus 80 Celsius.
You do everything with your controllers or with your hand like that. So let's go back to the data layers, geographic map like that. And now I have to Earth from space, virtual globe. Let's do the Earth. Oh, that's a new one. Let's do the thing is like that. Put it in here. It's loading, hopefully. A moment. Ah, yes, you have to put it over there. Oh, that's new. Then you can see the space Hubble telescope, GPS constellations and so on, open. And then you can do thingies like that. It's a do program, so, well, it's nice. So,
Earth's orbits are populated by a diverse array of artificial satellites, each serving unique functions and operating within specific orbital regimes.
Oh yes, let me tell you something about Elon Musk. Elon Musk is launching his Starlinks like that. And artificial intelligence said to me, ChatGPT Plus, that if Elon Musk keeps up launching his Starlinks rockets, there will be a Kessler effect. And the Kessler effect is a chain reaction of debris around the Earth, and space travel will be impossible. So Elon Musk and his dream to go to Mars are bullshit, absolute bullshit. Okay, let's go to another thingy. Change chapter. Okay. Yes, I want to change chapter. Let's go to the chapters. Let's go to the universe. Loading. Okay, here we go. Yes. Oh, this is the solar system. Okay. There I can see all the planets like that. You can view. You can labels on. There's the Earth. You can see the orbits like that, Venus, Mercury. So it's Newton's laws. The farther a planet is away from the sun, the slower it revolves, its gravity. So labels on, labels off, orbits on, orbits off. Far view, this is from a distance. Asteroid view, oh, this is new. So I can see the, wow, oh, I can touch the asteroid belt, wow. This is a great update. Well, there's so much. Oh yes, there's a lock on it because some things you cannot do because they will make a paying program. So there's an asteroid over there. Let's go to Milky Way. Milky Way. Loading. Yes, let's take the Milky Way like that. We're living somewhere in the spiral arm view info panel. One moment.
The Milky Way is a barred spiral galaxy spanning about 100,000 light years across and containing at least 100 billion stars. At its core lies a densely packed bulge within which resides a supermassive black hole known as Sagittarius A.
Okay.
The Milky Way was born about 13.6 billion...
And so on. So, do the info panel. Well, you have to click a lot of buttons. Labels on. Oh, yes. Light years. Okay. And we're living somewhere, Scutum Centauri arm, somewhere in the suburbs. And I have a dream. I want to solve the Fermi paradox. Well, what's the Fermi paradox? I will tell about this in a future video. Where are they? Because the universe is full of life. And the question is, where are they? So, let's go to the exoplanets. One moment, I have to click. No, I will change the chapter. Yes. Whoa. Waiting. Go to the solar system again. Yes. Want to see the planets. Because they did an update from the planets. It's loading. Well, the program takes some time to load. Oh, there it is. Yes. Yeah, there we are. So we will start with Mars, the dream of Elon Musk. Put it in the thingy over there. Let's see what happens. Okay, the planet Mars. One moment. View.
Mars, often called the Red Planet due to its distinctive rusty color, has been known to humanity since ancient times. Positioned fourth from the sun in our solar system, Mars is situated just beyond Earth. Similar to Earth in its day length and seasonal cycles, thanks to a comparable axial tilt, Mars is about half Earth's diameter and is only 38% of Earth's surface gravity. Its thin atmosphere, primarily composed of carbon dioxide, contributes to its cold desert landscape.
So, Elon Musk wants to colonize Mars, not in 10 years, not in 20 years, not in 30 years, let's say 300 or make it 500 years, because we don't have the technology. The moon labels. Let's visit the planet. Oh, this is something new. Visit the planet. Missions. Land on Mars. Let's go. Oh yes, I have a helmet on. Select the location you want to go. Let's go to Curiosity. Perseverance. Loading. Okay, here we go. Wow! I'm on Mars. And I feel like Matt Damon, the Martian. Ingenuity. Oh, this is great. You can put the hood on and off. Mars panel, yes. Just zero open. 3D model. Oh, yes, this is the crater like that. So I'm standing on Mars and there's Ingenuity. So Mars has a very thin atmosphere, but there are micrometeorites, radiation. Elon Musk is now supporting Donald Trump for only one reason, because his silly dream to go to Mars, and he will be a trillionaire or a zillionaire in 3 years' time. Well, to make a long story short, let's spend all that money for poverty in the world and hunger. Because going to Mars is a silly dream of a silly person. Well, he's on the autism spectrum, but then so am I. But I'm realistic, and Donald Trump is not realistic. He's just messing up our beautiful planet. Well, have to think now. Leave Mars surface. Yes. Well, you can download this program and have hours and hours of fun, because in a few months' time it will be available in a paying version. Some people will find it a bit primitive, but I say I like it. If you're an astronomy buff, you will like this program. Oh yes, this is the carbon dioxide here, and it's frozen carbon dioxide. It's not snow like that. Let's take Saturn. Okay, where do I put it? Over there. Yes. Saturn with its rings, because they did an update also over there. No, it's Uranus. Uranus. You don't have to say Uranus. So, well, there's nothing to see. I want Saturn. I said Saturn. Saturn, yes. Come on. No, there's a mistake in the program. Let's take the sun then. Okay. Well, this program is not made by an American, because I thought it was American thingies, but it's made by a Italian company. So, made in Unity like that. Well, there you have it. We'll leave the chapter. The chapter. Yes. The Earth. I will take the Earth again. I feel like Tony Stark in his costume like that. You know the movie, Tony Stark. Earth Moon System. Oh yes, that's something new. One moment. No. Available in full version. You have to pay for it. Oh, clever ones. So I will take the moon. Well, my advice is don't buy it, folks, because it's a bit amateur-like, in my opinion. It gets boring after a while. So the moon. So we're all dreaming going back to the moon. Oh, land on the moon. I will land on the moon. I said land on the moon. Land. No, doesn't work. Well, the program lacks intuition. It's very primitive. And, oh yes, I have to click on it. Apollo 11. Oh yes, one moment. I apologize. I forgot to click. Come on. Doesn't work. Well, available in full version. Well, you see. Okay. Let's go back to the chapter. Oh dear, I'm getting tired, you know. Universe, Earth. I said Earth. Well, I will stop here because the programming is a bit of disappointment. It's free for nothing, you can play with it, and I don't see future for this program. It's too complicated, and there's no logic in the program, and that's my final verdict. But I do like the music in the background. Okay, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next episode when I discover a new program in the MetaQuest 2 or 3, or there's an update like in EarthQuest. The update in EarthQuest was fantastic, but this update, it sucks. Thank you for watching, and if you like this video, give it a like. And if you don't like this video, well, go to Donald Trump or something. Okay, beam me up, Mr. Scotty.